that were kind of divinely inspired, which means that they just kind of burst themselves as I evolved. I guess you could say, or as I was evolving, I was opening up creatively, and certain things started popping into my head. So I mean, once you, I guess once your ears and eyes are open, you have to kind of pay attention a little bit more. So there were four or five. These are three that came through real clearly. The first one is called A Means to an End. Is the name of the first one. So
what is it?
A means to an end. So we can all be a means to an end. A good end. Thank you. my friend. Can warm the hearts and minds of men. And you first must be super consciousness, you know. I went to this church called First Unity. They talk about a super consciousness where everybody's kind of connected, you know, and the law of attraction and stuff kind of falls in with that, where you can, you know, we have, you tap into that and we can attract things to us, sort of. But I think of the super consciousness is more than just the here and now. Kind of like, I don't know if y'all have heard of the 1200 monkey thing, where, you know, anyway, so there was I'm not going to get into all that, but I believe that this super consciousness is not just about the here and now, but it's also about, it connects everybody now, everybody that's ever been, and everybody, anybody that ever will be. So there's like an infinite knowledge base out there, infinite lifetimes, infinite life experiences, etc. So I was in really deep meditation and started getting this stuff about I'm supposed to write this song. And I got 1969 came through, and then a Strawberry Sunday came through, which is kind of weird. So I'm like, okay, I know I'm supposed to do something. So I started researching it on the web and looking up stuff that was happening in 1969, which of course Vietnam and all kinds of stuff was happening. And then all of a sudden I ran across this page and it all started to kind of fall into place. There was an event called Bloody Sunday. So it wasn't about ice cream, it was about a day, Sunday. And Bloody Sunday, if you're not up on your black history, was one of the pivotal civil rights marches. It was really before Martin Luther King did a lot of his, before the bus thing, I believe, though Martha Parks was part of it. They were coming across this bridge, and the police were on the other side with their bullwhips and their dogs, and they beat those people real bloody, and they got it all on film. TV media was there, and it was one of the major turning points, one of the first really big points, were because white America saw, they were kind of a little bit in the heck of their head in the clouds. They didn't really understand the real depth of the whole thing. And when they saw this, it really changed everything. It started it really kicked the civil rights movement into high gear. This song is called The Natural Blues, and it's a it's about a black man that was a musician and a singer, and he's in an old folks home or one of those hospice kind of places, and he's sharing his pearls of wisdom with one of the interns there, because he's kind of starting to get a feeling like he's about to pass over. And I actually wrote, my ex did, she used to do spoken word a lot. So I gave a hand at writing this word piece. I'm not going to do it for you because it's a little long and monotonous, but I actually go into what happened to the guy after he passes over, about the life cord passing through his hands, and he has all these pretty wild experiences. But that in itself is kind of cool, but this is called The Natural Blues. Thank you.
Sunday back at 6 to 5. I was just trying to stay alive, singing protest songs on Fifth Avenue. Vietnam, free love, F-45s, holding Jenny's hand in mine. I wish to God she made it through. Thank you.
listening to Mike Owen, songwriter and performer, and hopefully he won't rush off. And when we finish the Q&A session, hopefully he'll do another song for us. Right, Mike?
Yes, sir. My the very first one I wrote. I sang it today at Science of Mind Church Open Heart this morning. It's called God's Love for You.
Sail across an ocean on a boat that I call faith, and ventured out to see if I can touch the face of God. With each passing day, my fears grow stronger and stronger. Darkness that enfolds, time and space control me. Seems I built some kind of wall that stands between who I am and the person who I always dreamed I'd be. A small voice that screams inside me. It says, feast on the mind of abundance and light. Search for the truth and illuminate sight. See through the eyes of an innocent child again. Love like a river flows wide and deep. Streams of compassion and truth, a never-ending fountain of grace. This God's love for you. This God's love for you.
If you missed any of the program today, then it will be on, get one of my cards. It's got the blogtalkradio.com/Renford. It'll be on the Core Concepts radio show, and it will eventually be on internet television too. We've got that set up. We're just working on the details. Okay? Have a good time. Have a drink. Visit a little bit. You don't have to run off.